Lord, and here am I to give my all. I know in my soul what you expect of me, and all that more I shall be. A knight at the Table Round should be invincible. Succeed where less fantastic men would fail. Climb alone, no one else can climb. With the dragon breath in time. Swim alone in a coat of heavy iron mail. No man for pain, he ought to be unwinceable. Impossible deed should be his daily fare. But where in the world is there in the world a man so extraordinaire? C'est moi. C'est moi, I'm forced to admit, 'tis I humbly reply, that mortal who these marvels can do, c'est moi, c'est moi. I've never lost in battle or game. I'm simply the best by far. When swords are crossed, 'tis always the same. One blow and au revoir. Say what, how admirably fit a French Prometheus unbound. And here I stand with valor untold, incredibly brave, amazing. To serve at the Table Round. The soul of a knight should be a thing remarkable. His heart and his mind as pure as morning dew. With a will and self-restraint, that's the envy of every saint. He could easily work a miracle or two. To love and desire, he ought to be unsparkable. The ways of the flesh should offer no allure. But where in the world is there in the world a man so untouched and pure? C'est moi, I blush to disclose, I'm far too noble to lie. That man in whom these qualities bloom, c'est moi, tis I. I've never strayed from all I believe. I'm blessed with an iron will. Had I been made the partner of Eve, we'd be in Eden still. C'est moi, the angels have chose to fight their battles below. And here I stand as pure as a prayer, incredibly clean, with virtue to the godliest man I know.
I cannot bring in two, Lancelot. You gave him a shattering blow. The echo broke several branches in the trees.
There's water in the flask. Toss it in his face and hurry. Oh, King Arthur, what caliber of man you must be to have conceived of the Round Table, to have created a new order of life. I worship you before knowing you. No harm must befall you. Beware, enemies of Arthur. Do you hear me? Beware. From this moment on, you answer to me.
What a blow. What a blow. Magnificent. Simply magnificent.
Now that you have recovered, sir, I bid you good day. And remember, the next time you raise a spear at me, you challenge the right arm of King Arthur.
Wait, I am King Arthur.
The king?
Almost the late king.
I struck you. Oh my God. Your Majesty, I am Lancelot du Lac. I heard of your new order in France and I came to join you. Oh, I beg your Majesty to forgive me. Not because I deserve it, but by forgiving me, I'll suffer more.
Really, dear chap, I don't want you to suffer at all. I want to congratulate you. Please rise. And you too, Squire.
I cannot. Too ashamed to lift my head.
Then I command you. I tell you, I've never felt a bash in the chest like it. It was spectacular. Where did you learn to do it?
My skill comes from training, Your Majesty. My strength from purity.
Oh. unique recipe, I must say.
He's a unique man, Your Majesty. At the age of 14, he could defeat any jouster in France. His father, King Ben, made him his
King Ben? Of Benwick? What did you say your name was?
Lancelot du Lac, Your Majesty.
Lancelot! My word! You're Lancelot! Of course! I was told you were coming!
You were told, Your Majesty?
By Merlin, our court magician. He said to me one day, Arthur, keep your eye out for Lancelot du Lac from the castle of Joyous Guard. He will come to the court of Camelot and he shall be... What was it?
Your ally, if you'll take me! Your friend who asks not friendship, your defender,
when you need one, whose heart is already filled with you, whose body, your sword to brandish. Did he prophesy that, Your Majesty? For all that, I am.
Really, my dear fellow, it's almost more than one can hope for. More than one should ask.
Then you'll accept me.
Oh yes, without hesitation. We must arrange for your knighthood immediately.
Oh no, not immediately, Your Majesty. Not till I have proven myself to you. All you know of me now is words. Invest me because of deeds, sire. Give me a word.
Now?
Yes, now. This minute. Send me on a mission. Let me perform for you. Is there some wrong I can right? Some enemy I can battle? Some peril I can undertake?
Well, there's actually not much going on today. It's the 1st of May, and the Queen and some of the court have gone away. I was on my way to surprise her when you surprised me.
Gone a maid, Your Majesty.
Yes, it's a sort of picnic. You eat grapes and chase girls around trees.
Picnic, Your Majesty?
Well, yes. It's a custom we have here. England, you know. It's the time for flower gathering.
Knights gathering flowers, Your Majesty.
Well, someone has to do it.
But there's so much to be done!
Precisely because there is so much to be done.
Of course, sir.
Besides, it's civilized. Civilizations need a few gentle hobbies. And I want you to meet the Queen.
I should be honored. Dad, take the horses to the castle, feed them and dress them for battle.
For battle? But there's no one to fight today.
One never knows, Your Majesty. Enemies seldom take holidays.
I suppose not. You know, Merlin told me...
What is it, sire? Did I say something that displeased you? Have I offended you?
No, no, Lancelot. I suddenly remembered what Merlin said of you. How strange. How wondrous. He told me that you would be the greatest knight to ever sit at my table. That was long before I even conceived of a table. So he knew it would exist. I thought he meant a dining table. But he meant this, the round table. So I've stumbled upon my future. I have done the right thing.
Did you ever doubt it, Your Majesty?
Of course I did. Only fools never doubt. Welcome, Lancelot. Bless you for coming, and welcome to the table.
Thank you. England.
Oh, really?
How do you do, Your Majesty? We'll have to fog out the bending, beastly hinges need oiling, been slipping out for 18 years. Do forgive what? No, it isn't proper, but there you are. I'll be with you in a minute. Oh, it stopped raining. Name of King Pelinor. May have heard me. What? No matter. You say you haven't seen a beast with the head of a serpent. Oh,
please, you? I beg you, don't describe it again. It sounds much too revolting. We have not seen it?
They called the questing beast the curse of the Pelinors. Only a Pelinor can catch her. That is all his next of kin. Family tradition. Train all the Pelinors with that idea in mind, yes. Limited education, what? By the way, where am I now?
Don't you know?
Haven't the foggiest. Oh, very easy to laugh, but nothing jocular about it to yours truly. Always mollicking about after that beastly beast. Nowhere to sleep, never knowing where you are. Rheumatism in the winter. Sunstroke in the summer! All this horrid armor that takes hours to put on, then sitting up all night polishing the beastly stuff. But I'm a Pelinor, and I, it's my fate. But sometimes I do wish I had a nice house of my own to live in, with beds in it, and real pillows and sheets in it. Oh, what? Come on, be a man. Where did you say I was?
I didn't, but I will.
You're
in Camelot.
Thank you. Camelot? Horrid we've been through here, haven't we? Look around. Oh, you wouldn't know, all you can see is hair. But I remember something. Oh, hello, you've changed your frock.
I'm here.
Oh, yes, of course. I spent a lovely day here years ago with a nice young chap who used to change himself into a bunny rabbit. Name of Walt. Ever meet him, a lady?
Constantly. He's my husband, King Arthur of England.
By Jove, is he now? Good for him! That's my idea of getting on. Yours fondly thought he was grand. Simply grand. I liked him better when he was himself than when he was a bunny. He was a nice, clean, domesticated bunny. But I had a feeling
he was mixing with some very funny bunnies.
Do say hello to him for me, won't you? Won't take any more of your time. Have to mullock on, what? Come along, Horrid. Horrid, did you hear the news? You remember Wart, who used to change himself into a bunny rabbit? Well, he's changed himself into the King of England. I call that jolly clever.
My lord, I'm sure the king would love to see you again. Wouldn't you care to spend the night?
Spend the night? Out of the way, you vicious beast!
Yes?
In a house?
In a bed.
A bed?
A feather bed.
Would it have pillows?
Down pillows.
Oh, I'd love that. By George, I would. That's wonderfully kind of you, ma'am. He sleeps somewhere else.
Where would you like him to sleep?
Oh, anywhere around the castle will do. The moat might be nice for him. I don't really like him very much, though. No earthly use to me. Plays a bit of piano, too much left paw, you know. Mrs. Queen, when you get down to the brass tacks of it, he may look like an unmade bed, but actually, he's a dog. A pointer! The only thing is, you never know which way he's pointing. Easily to without him.
He shall sleep in the stable. Clavius, would you escort our guests to the castle?
This is too nice for words, ma'am. Most grateful. What a glorious day. There's even a hint of summer in the air. Or is that you, Horrid?
Why, Joe, what a curse! Mollicking about after that beastly beast! What?
What
a delightful surprise, Arthur.
What's happened here? Ginny, I want you to...
Forgive us, Arthur. We have just encountered an absolute cartoon of a man called King Pellinore.
Pellinore? Why, I know him from my boyhood. A delicious fellow.
I have invited him to stay for the night.
Oh, splendid, Ginny. Ginny, this is Lancelot du Lac from the Castle of Joyous Guard.
My lord.
Your Majesty.
This is the Lancelot that Merlin spoke of. He's come all the way from France to become a knight of the Round Table.
Welcome, my lord. I hope your journey was pleasant.
I'm honored to be among you, your Majesty. And allow me to pledge to her Majesty my eternal dedication to this inspired cause.
Thank you, my lord. How charming of you to join us, Arthur.
This splendid dream must be a universal reality.
Oh, absolutely. It really must. Can you stay for lunch?
I have assured His Majesty that he may call upon me at any time to perform any deed, no matter the risk.
Thank you, my lord. That's most comforting. Arthur, this
is... I'm always on duty.
Yes, I can see that. Can you stay, Arthur?
With pleasure, my love. I want you to hear the new plan that we've been discussing. Explain it, Lancelot.
To Her Majesty, sire. Would Her Majesty not find the complicated affairs of chivalry rather tedious?
Not at all, my lord. I have never found chivalry tedious so far. May I remind you, my lord, that the Round Table happens to be my husband's idea.
Any idea, however exalted, could be improved.
Really?
Yes. I had suggested to His Majesty that we create a training program for knights.
Marvelous idea, isn't it?
A training program?
Yes, it's a program for training.
Yes, Your Majesty. That must be a standard established. An unattainable goal that, with work, becomes attainable. Not only in arms, but in thought. An indoctrination of noble Christian principle.
And whose abilities would serve as the standard, my lord?
No, certainly not mine, Your Majesty. It would not be fair.
Not fair in what way?
I would never ask anyone to live by my standards, Your Majesty. To dedicate your life to the tortured quest for perfection in body and spirit. Oh, no. I would not ask that of anyone.
Nor would I. Have you achieved perfection, my lord?
Physically, yes, Your Majesty. But the refining of the soul is an endless struggle.
I dare say. I do dare say. Do you mean to tell me you've never been defeated in battle or tournament?
Never, Your Majesty.
I see. And I gather you consider it highly unlikely ever to happen in the future.
Oh, highly, Your Majesty.
How is the channel? Did you have a rough crossing?
Now tell me a little of your struggle for the perfection of the spirit.
But I want you to hear more about the training program, Jenny.
I'm much more interested in his spirit and his noble Christian principles. Tell me, my lord, have you come to grips with humility lately, my lord?
Humility, Your Majesty?
I think we had better discuss the training program elsewhere. Not here, not now. You look far too beautiful, my love, to have anything on your mind but frolicking flowers. Have a lovely day. And to all of you, come, lads.
Good day, my lady.
Quickly.
By George, that Frenchman is an unpleasant fellow. He seems to have the king wrapped around his finger.
He's so poisonously good.
He probably walked across the channel.
Sir Dinadan.
Your Majesty.